Kampala City Traders Association, KASITA, has called off its strike after Prime Minister Rebinan Nabbanja reportedly gave a written assurance on Thursday that the government would address their grievances. On Wednesday this week, traders started a strike temporarily closing their shops for 2 days after the abrupt cancellation of a highly anticipated meeting with President Yoweri Museveni aimed to resolve contested tax regimes and the rollout of the electronic fiscal receipting and invoicing solution, IFRIS.
Twebaza abasuubuzi okutegeera ebituluma ne tuba nga tukkiriziganyizaamu mu ngeri ey'okwesomesa nti abaaye bwe tutalwana ng'ate tulwana mu birembe kwaffe tetwokya mipiira tetukasuka mayinja amaanyi nga gabadde mu kisumuluzo kyaffe era kati tukiraga.
Tubalaze ekituufu kye muyina okukola tulabe nga twenunula mu mirimu. Ebigambo bye tubagamba ng'abakulembeze tetulina musuubuzi yenna gwe tukotogera nti leero takola kubanga nange ayogera wano nange ndi musuubuzi. So tubakubira omulanga nti musigale nga mukyali consistent ku bigambo bye twayogedde kubanga bye twetaaga omukulembeze w'eggwanga twabimugamba.
The meeting with the president, which was scheduled for July 31st, was called off via SMS from Kampala Minister Minsa Kabanda, sparking outrage among the business community. Security forces were deployed in the central business district to deter any probable disruptions and ensure law and order in the city. On Friday, Kabanda said the president is still committed to meeting the traders. However, the intended meeting venue, Kolo Independence Ground, is undergoing renovations. The chairperson of KASITA, Dr. Thaddeus Musoke, and John Kabanda, the chairperson of the Federation of Uganda Traders Association, said in a joint statement that they agreed with the president to reschedule the meeting that was meant to take place this Thursday.
The government is taking us for granted. And also, she was emphasizing about submission of proposals without mentioning about the challenges which we have been engaging the government and which we clearly presented to His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. So that's why the traders had to communicate in a more peaceful way.
Among the grievances raised by the traders are the taxation method applied to textiles based on weight, the disruptive presence of foreign traders in local businesses, the proposed increase on the VAT threshold from 150 million shillings to 1 billion shillings, excessive tax rate, the need for tax value harmonization, rollout of electronic fiscal receipting and invoicing solution, IFRIS. President Museveni first met with the traders on May 2nd at Kolo Ceremonial Grounds, where they revised concerns about the challenges they face in conducting their businesses.
I want to educate our people. These penalties of who did not pay, locking their shops, they must be open, their shops. All their shops should be open. And I want to find out who locked up the shops in spite of my previous order. Have the flexible way of paying cash if you want, or paying later, but within the financial year.
Nabbanja told Parliament on Thursday that the Minister of Finance and Trade, as well as the leadership of KASITA, held a meeting and some traders agreed to open their shops. The Prime Minister said the President is still committed to meeting the traders and that the date for the next meeting will be communicated. She urged traders to open their shops pending communication from the President. The meeting between President Museveni and the city traders was initially scheduled for Thursday, June 20th, 2024, at Kolo Ceremonial Grounds, then postponed to July 31st and now postponed to an unknown date.